Hey everyone, today I am back doing another video. This video is going to be a tag video, and this tag is called the Beauty and Brains tag. So in this tag, there are 14 questions dealing with beauty and brains. So I'm just gonna go ahead and get started. So if you wanna see my answers to the Beauty and Brains tag questions, then just keep on watching. So the first question in this tag is favorite book. I don't really have like a favorite book. Let's see. Some other books that I read in school. I loved The Great Gatsby when I read that in high school. I'm trying to think of like other books I like. Like I said, I don't really have like a favorite book. I love reading like autobiographies. Sorry, the light's changing because the sun just came out. But anyways, I love reading like autobiographies. Those are like one of my favorite books to read. Like of course, one of my favorite, this isn't an autobiography, but a biography that I read was the one on Walt Disney, of course. So any of those kind of books I really like, but yeah, sorry, I don't really have like a favorite book. Next question is favorite quote or quotes. And I actually have like a list of quotes in my phone. I don't know why, maybe that sounds weird, but just kind of like quotes that I just really liked and that I've saw over the years. One of my favorite quotes that I saw, I don't know who said it, and I just saw it like on a sign outside of a church, like near my house. And this was many years ago, but the quote was, "If you can't love God, then you can't love anyone else." And I just really like that quote, and I think it has a lot of meaning to it. Another quote that I really like, again, I don't know who it's by. I think I just saw it like written somewhere. I don't really know. But it's, "If your dreams don't scare you, then they're not good enough." And I just really like that. I feel like this quote is just really important as well when it comes to following your dreams and your passion and doing what you want to do in life. And just kind of like pushing yourself to do or to go out of the box. And I don't know, I think especially for me, this quote is really important for me because I'm someone that's very like, you know, quiet and kind of like in the background, and I don't really like go out of my box really to like try new things and to try things that scare me. And I think honestly, I think in life that's kind of important because you only live once and you really shouldn't be afraid to live your life and to try new things. And if you want to do this with your life or you want to accomplish this goal, you shouldn't be, just because you're scared of it, you shouldn't like shy away from it. You should just go for it. So that's kind of why I really like that quote. Question number three, English or math? I definitely like math better than English. And I think in some ways I'm kind of better at math than English. That sounds really weird, but honestly, you guys, like, and you've probably even like known this through like watching my videos, like I'm terrible at speaking English. Like I'm terrible at speaking my own language. Like how sad is that? The only language that I know, and I like don't know how to speak it at all. Like I'm terrible when it comes to grammar, and I'm terrible when it comes to like writing papers. Like I don't really know how to properly punctuate a sentence, and this sounds really sad, but it's true. Question number four, science or art? Definitely science. I never liked art. I really only took art like in intermediate school, and I was like, and elementary school as well. And I don't know, I've never liked art, never liked taking art, so definitely science. Question number five, name five albums or musical artists that have changed your life. Honestly, I don't think I really have like any albums or musical artists that have changed my life, so I guess I'll just list five that I really like and have liked over the years. So I guess one I'll mention is my Disney Princess CD that I have. That's definitely number one because if you guys know me, I love Disney princesses, and like that CD is honestly one of my favorites. Like I got it for Christmas from my sister Brie, and I literally cried when I got it because I don't know, like Disney just has me feeling some type of way. Like it just means so much to me, and it like really connects me back to my childhood. And I just absolutely love the music and like Disney movies, and that's pretty much what's on the CD, just songs from Disney princess movies specifically. And yeah, so I guess in a way, yes, that has changed my life for the better. Like it just makes me so happy, and I just absolutely love Disney. I guess another one I'll mention is Hilary Duff. I have a few of her CDs, and I loved her growing up, and I went to one of her concerts when I was like, maybe like 11 or 12? 10, something like that. I went to one of her concerts, and I loved Hilary Duff growing up. Like I truly did. And I would just, you know, when I was younger, I would just blast her music and sing along to it at the top of my lungs in my room. And I had posters of her in my room. Like I just loved Hilary Duff, and I still listen to her to this day, like her older CDs. She did come out with a newer one like maybe last year or the year before or something like that. But yeah, so definitely Hilary Duff when it comes to her music and also like her movies and TV shows, like Lizzie McGuire is alive, okay? Like, so I guess, yeah, Hilary Duff has changed my life in some ways. Okay, three more. This is hard. These next two, I guess, in a way have changed my life, or I've listened to literally since I was like a baby, basically, is Michael Jackson and Frank Sinatra. I really got into Michael Jackson and Frank Sinatra from my dad, especially Frank Sinatra, because my dad loves Frank Sinatra. So I definitely got into Frank Sinatra and Michael Jackson when I was really, really young. And that's pretty much all we would listen to, like with my dad, like me, my sister, and my dad. We would just listen to them and we would just dance around my dad's apartment. And yeah, and still to this day, I love Michael Jackson, his music, and I love Frank Sinatra's music. So yeah, I guess those two have definitely had an impact on my life since I was very, very young. And one more, this is so hard. Like, I really don't think I can think of another one. So yeah, I'm gonna cheat a little bit and just include four because I really can't think of like a fifth musical artist or album that I've like absolutely loved. Which I mean, I guess I really like all of my CDs and like all the musical artists I listen to. I love all of them, but I just can't think of, I can't really pinpoint one that I'm like, oh my gosh, like, you know what I mean? So sorry, I'm gonna cheat a little bit and just include four and move on to the next question. Question number six, favorite and least favorite subjects in school. My favorite subject in school was probably, I guess in general, science. I really specifically like anatomy, some biology. Those are probably like my favorite. My least favorite, when I was like younger, well, I guess a little bit in college too. I've only had like one type of this class in college, but like any kind of like social studies or history, I just never was a big fan of. I mean, some of the things we would talk about and learn about like from our past was kind of interesting, but overall I just found it really boring and I could just never get into it. Question number seven, favorite celebrity with a brain? To be perfectly honest, I don't even know if I'm gonna answer this question. I don't really like that question because I think that's kind of mean. Like, I feel like you can't really say that one celebrity's, well, I guess there are people that are smarter than other people, but I don't know. I don't really like this question, and I can't even really think of a celebrity with a brain that I like or that's my favorite. So I'm just gonna move on to the next one. Sorry, I'm really cheating in this tag. Question number eight, if you could study anything anywhere, what would it be? I don't know. I mean, I guess it would be kind of cool to like go to like another country or something and study something, but I don't really know what that would be. I guess, like I said previously, like my favorite subject in school is like anything to do with like science, like anatomy and biology and things like that. So maybe I would want to study something like that, like the human body. I'm really interested in the human body. So maybe I could like study the human body like somewhere. I don't know like where that would be, but that would be kind of cool. Question number nine, what is your nerdy little secret? I guess my nerdy little secret would be I love doing homework and I love reading. I mean, sometimes I get really stressed out with it, obviously, because I'm human, and sometimes school, especially being in college, it gets really stressful. But yeah, like sometimes on the weekends, that's like my favorite thing to do is like either read or do homework, and I would rather do that than like anything else. And I've kind of always been like that in school. Like, I've always loved to do homework. I would even do other people's homework. I don't know why I would do that, but yeah, so I guess that's my nerdy little secret. Question number 10, favorite beauty gurus that you admire for more than their love for beauty and fashion. Pretty much every beauty guru I watch, I really genuinely like. I mean, I don't just watch them for their makeup and everything like that. Of course, I watch so many, but of course, like when it comes to like a question like this, I blank on like all of them. So I guess just some beauty gurus I like, and I don't even know if these are like technically beauty gurus, but these are just some women that I watch on YouTube that I really like and I admire, and that would definitely be Trisha Paytas, Graveyard Girl or Bunny, It's Judy's Life or It's Judy's Time, Sinead from The Makeup Chair. Those are just a few beauty gurus or just YouTubers that I really like to watch on YouTube that I admire for more than the, I guess, the regular videos they do on YouTube. Question number 11, if your channel couldn't focus on beauty and fashion, what would it be? This is actually a really easy question because my channel, I feel like I kind of just do everything. I don't specifically focus on like one topic. Not only do I do, I guess, kind of beauty videos, like makeup videos, I'll do like mostly like get ready with me's and sometimes I'll do tutorials. But on my channel, I do a lot of videos on like other things. Like I guess like to kind of go along with this tag, like the nerdiness is I'll do book reviews. And I don't really do them a lot because I don't really have a lot of time to read. And when I do have time to read, I'm the slowest reader ever. So I don't really do a lot of book reviews. I wish I had more time. But anyway, so I'll do book reviews. I'll do, I guess nail tutorials kind of goes with beauty. I'll do tag videos and I'll do vlogs as well. So that's kind of the beauty of my channel is I don't just focus on like one little set of videos. I'll just kind of do a little bit of everything and just whatever I want. Question number 12, name some things that you are obsessed with that other people would find strange or geeky. Well, I kind of already answered this question previously, and another question is, I really like reading and doing homework, and I know a lot of people don't like doing that, especially doing homework. They don't really find the fun in it, and I do. Some other things I'm obsessed with, I guess Disney. I know I do get a lot of like weird questions like, well, you're not a little kid, even though I look like a little kid. You're not a little kid, like why do you like Disney? And it's like, that's just kind of a stupid question because like, why do you have to be a kid to like Disney? But whatever. So I guess people would kind of find that strange when they find out I'm like obsessed with Disney. Yeah, I guess kind of overall, all the things I'm like obsessed with are like things that kids would be obsessed with. Like I still watch like little kid shows. Like, okay, not like little kids. I don't like watch like Dora the Explorer or like Caillou, not like those kinds. But I still watch like cartoon shows that I used to watch when I was a kid. And like old Disney Channel shows that I used to watch as a kid, I'll still watch those and I still love them. And yeah, just kind of overall, I just really like things that like kids would like. And like, there's so many times I'll go to a store and I'll see toys and I literally want to get them for myself. And so I guess people would find that strange, but I'm just truly a little kid at heart. Question number 13, name 5 people excluding friends and family who inspire you. Again, I don't know if I can answer this one, at least not like 5 people, because I don't know, this may sound weird or people may think I'm like lying or something, but like I don't really feel like there's that many people that inspire me that are like excluding friends and family. Like definitely my parents inspire me for sure, but since this is excluding friends and family, I don't think I can think of 5 people that inspire me. So I guess I'll just pick one, which probably you guys already know who this is, but it's definitely Walt Disney. Walt Disney totally inspires me, and I'm like, I'm just so obsessed with Disney and Walt Disney. Like, I don't know what is wrong with me, but I just absolutely love him. And just kind of like my own research I've done on him and like books I've read on him, I just like love him. Like as like a person, like I just feel like he was such an amazing person. And I feel like people might disagree with me because I've heard so many rumors of like how Walt Disney was such like a terrible person. And I don't even know how like rumors like that got started, because like doing my own research and my own reading on him, like he was not a terrible person at all, and he was like such a good family man and everything like that. So I don't know where all these rumors got started, but anyways, that's like a totally other subject and video probably. But yeah, so instead of naming 5 people that are excluding friends and family that inspire me, I'm just gonna name one, and that would definitely be Walt Disney. And question number 14, who is your intellectual soulmate? Again, I don't know if I can answer this question. This is a hard tag. Like, there's so many questions on here that I just, like, feel like I can't answer. But, yeah, there's really, like, not, like, one person that I would say is, like, my intellectual soulmate, and, like, they wouldn't just be my soulmate just because they're smart. I don't know. Okay, anyways, that is the end of this tag. Sorry, it was kind of like a fail because a few of the questions I couldn't really answer. But, anyways, I really hope you all enjoyed this video. Anyways, and if you did, please make sure to give it a thumbs up. And before I go, I want to give a shout out to a few of my new subscribers today. Fluffy People 101, Unicorns Rule 202, BD Works by Iris, Morgan M, Gracie G, Levi M, Catherine P, and Vicky D. Paz. Sorry if I didn't pronounce that right, but I want to say hi to you guys. Thank you so much for subscribing to me and watching my videos. I really appreciate it, and I really hope you all enjoyed this video. And until my next video, I hope you all have a wonderful day, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye, everyone.